Hello, good day, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. I still remain your girl, Zion Creativity. Today, I'd like to quickly take us on how to draft a bustier cut with a free hand. In a situation whereby you have no tool around, you should be able to improvise. I'm working on an half-scale bodies with the length 15.5 inches. I added 2.5 inches for seam hemming allowance. I mean the allowance that we need at the hemline and the shoulder level. Because it's a bustier cut, you need to add like 2.5 inches just because there are going to be alterations at the bust area. But if it's a regular half scale bodies, 1 inch is okay for the hemming allowance. So the next thing now is to measure the armhole line, which is also regarded as the chest line. In freehand, the standard measurement for the armhole is 9 inches for an average person. So the next thing now is to draft the bust point, the bust line. Because we are drafting directly on the fabric, you need to have add 1/2 inch for hemming allowance at the shoulder level. And since the length measurement is 10 inches, I added 1/2 inch. And that gives me 10.5 for the bust line. So I marked 10.5 for the bust line. So then you connect your armhole to join to the shoulder. Connect it to the shoulder to give you that square shape. So the next thing now is to mark my nipple to nipple, which is also regarded as the bust pan. The client's nipple to nipple is 3.5 inches. So because we are drafting on the fabric, add 1/2 inch seam allowance, and that gives me 4 inches. So I marked 4 inches for the bust pan. So sorry, I forgot to mark the under bust line. So the client's under bust line is 14 inches. So do not forget to add 1/2 inch seam allowance because you're drafting directly on the fabric. So that gives me 14.5 inches for the under bust of that client. So on the under bust line, mark the bust span, mark it on the waistline too, and connect it together. So using the bust pan line as the center, mark 1.5 inches to this side and 1/2 inch to this side on the center front. Same thing on the under bust line, mark 1/2 inch and 1.5 inches to this side too. Connect the lines together. Likewise, this center front too, connect it together. Then to the bust point, come down by 1 inch. Come down by 1 inch and connect it to the under bust with your hand or the ruler. If you use ruler, you need to shape it. Don't make it just straight. It has to be curved a little bit. So all the markings gives me 2 inches. 1.5 on one side and 1/2 inch on the other side, on the side of the center front. For the neckline, you can use the standard measurement of 3 inches or whatever you like. But here I use 3 inches for the width and 3.5 inches for the depth. So going back to the armhole, try and make a curve to give you the shape of the armhole. You can start from 6 inches, then you curve it like this. So that gives you the armhole. Then you slant it by 1 inch. You know the shoulder is not straight. You slant it by 1 inch to the neckline. Still on the armhole. I'm still working on the armhole. You look for the midpoint. You know my armhole has reduced to 8. You look for the midpoint. Then from the bust point, you come up by 1 inch. then you mark it. So from there you connect that armhole to the bust point to give you that princess dart shape. Then curve it very well. You can see our bustier cut is ready. We move forward to insert the bust circumference, which is 9.5 inches. After dividing it by 4, you had 2 inches seam allowance, and because of that place you had 1 inch, because there's going to be a slit at that place. Then to the waistline, you insert the waist circumference. After that you insert 2 inches seam allowance and 2 inches this dart allowance. You connect it together and you cut. Everything is ready. I'm just trying to shape that place very well. Then you connect the neckline to the width and the depth. There's a hole on that table, so that's why I couldn't do that place very well. You can see. Then you cut out your markings. So here, just because it's a princess dart, you need to add to the shoulder, of which was still going to trim it out after sewing it. You just need to add 1 inch so that by the time you are sewing it, everything will align together. So now we have like 3 pieces, and on this piece you just trim off 1/2 inch. On this piece, on this center front piece, you trim off 1/2 inch, and these side pieces, this one is 2 pieces, you trim off 1 inch. Just 1 inch, you trim it off. So guys, thanks so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel and hit on the notification button so as to get alert anytime I upload another video. Thanks so much. I love you. I love you so much. Thanks for watching. The bustier cut is ready. And that is it. Thank you.